double fried French fries, that's what. The right potato, the right cooking method, and you've got the crispiest, fluffiest fry around. Reminds me of my days of peeling potatoes. Did something bad in the kitchen. You're the one that got to peel them all. Okay, but this is worth it because this is going for some dynamite fries. Actually, I call them double cut fries. What happens is I take the skin off the center here, leave a little bit on the ends, cut these bad boys down. I'll make a little area that I can balance my potato off, taking a piece off the back, then slicing it about 3/8 of an inch all the way through. Stack up just a couple pieces. Don't want to manage too many of them sliding around on each other. Give it an equal cut on that side. And there you go. Almost a perfect looking fry. Check that out. Okay? So we pop these into some water, leach out some of that starch. So we should be running right around 320, 315 to around 330. We're good. And I got some oil going that I'm going to throw these fries into. I'm going to do a double fry, as I called it. Oil and water scare me. Okay? Let me get some towels. Now what happens here is the first time I cook these, I'm really just kind of cooking the potato. I'm not really going for a browning. That's what's kind of misunderstood, I think, when people are making French fries at home. They think, well, I'll just take the fries and I'll just throw them in there. And well, they turn brown, so they're done. And then they're kind of soft in the middle. It's kind of like baked potato-y in the middle. And the idea that we're looking for is it takes a lot to cook a French fry and pull that moisture out to get the crisp. They may look nice and brown on the outside, but they're gonna be a little bit soggy. This is how you're gonna fight that. So. Take this here, put them down. Don't want to put water into that if we don't have to. Shake some off, okay? Give them a little dry. Somewhat dry, okay? Now we're gonna go and throw them in, kind of cook them through. We'll pull them out, let them cool down, and then we'll fry them again, and that's when the crunch will go on. So watch your hands. And this temperature's a little bit lower. We're gonna be up into the 350, 360 range when we do the potatoes for the crunch. Now, don't overload this, because one of the things we wanna remember is about the temperature. What temperature is this recovering to? You know, if you put too many things into your oil, or if your vessel that you got your oil in can't retain its own heat, well, it drops down, and that's when things kinda get soggy and real oily tasting. Okay, there we go. Let those bad boys hang out. Now, the fries, well, I've cooked them to where they're done. So that's a cooked potato. Now what, I've let them cool. Now what I'm gonna do is take the potatoes, put them back into the oil. The oil temperature's come back. It's what we call recovered. So now I'm gonna take them, throw them back in at 350. There we go. In small batches, not too much. Throw them back in at 350. This is where that nice golden crunch is gonna come in. These are just about done. Now these are the twice fry on the potato. Remember, I cut some russets. Took the skins off the side, left them on the end so they look, you know, kind of restaurant style. Got these bad boys, fried them once, let them cool down, then fried them again, and that's where the crunch comes from. Shut down the thermal reactor right there. Hit a little salt while they're hot so the salt kind of melts right into them. And then just shake them onto that platter. Ha ha, this is a big game day feed here.